What's happening, guys? Cowboy here, and we are back, continuing on with Dragon Age Inquisition. We knocked out that one Astrarium, and I noticed a little mission hiding over here, so there's a fatal fall. We're going to figure out what caused this fatal fall. A mystery accident. That's the Astrarium. This is the fatal fall. But we're going to investigate this. We are looking to wrap up Emerald Graves this episode, which I'm thinking we can do, as long as we stay on task and don't get too distracted by running around and picking up assorted loot piles. Oh, what's this?
Let's look around. Big gushing streams. I'm starting to feel inadequate.
God damn it, Bull. Everite? What is that? I don't think I've collected that before. That looks like a blood splatter. Oh, no, wait. Never mind. That's probably just the drawing. My bad. So, we're gonna... First, we're gonna do is kill these guys. Red Templar Guard with a... Red Templar Shadow, huh? Huh. It thinks it's gonna get away. Oh, the hidden blades on Hiproc. Oh my god! The Red Templar shit all over me. Hang on, we are a nightmare, I suppose, so. There you go. You enjoy that, dickhead. Ooh, a plush fuchsian velvet. If only it was Fade Touched. That's the Hidden Blades proc for 5. Pretty awesome. And now I know who to kill for it. So apparently the Fade Touched Velvets, those are just for, or not Velvets, but Fade Touched Cloth in general. You get it from just random drop of killing the appropriate enemy. So in this case, it would be the high-end Red Templar guys out in this area and wherever else you can find them. Alright, so we're heading on up. Gonna investigate the fall. If I can get over these fucking rocks. Come on, you can do it. Hardcore parkour, get your ass up there. It looks like an Astrarium is also up here, but I don't think this is the right way to go. I kinda like that move. It's like she's doing a... It's like a fucking Shoryuken! Shoryuken! Right, and we got a camp out here in the middle of freaking nowhere. Inquisitor, if you have a moment. No, I do not. Hey, Fade Rift's showing up. Nice. And I don't think I want to go this way. I was hoping I could, like, get over that ledge, but apparently not. Where do these Fade Rifts open up? Oh, wow, so this area expands out quite a bit. I will have to save some of these rifts. Well, maybe not. I've been trying to, like, save a couple rifts for the build videos, of course, but I think I still got a while before level 20, so if I can freaking find out how to get over there, I could knock that out, but oh, maybe this wraps all the way around. Rush of size. Well, there's a rift here. Might as well knock it out real fast. I claim this quarry. What do we got? A bunch of wraiths? That's it? I remembered wraiths being a hell of a lot weaker than this. Overreaching just a little bit there, Bull.
Thank you.
did you come from, Despair Demon? Another rift goes down. I don't know why no one's healing though. There's plenty of potions. It's like you guys just don't want to heal. For whatever odd reason. Intense lightning essence. Ooh. I think the Astrarium, we go this way and just hop over. We're gonna try that. I do like collecting all three. Always get some pretty badass loot out of doing that. What is over here? What is the hostels? Oh, wow. Big ass fucking bear. Huh. Look at the marksman. Shank. This bear is just going to town on the Red Templar. I kind of want to just watch. My group's getting involved in the bear, so we'll take him out of the equation. Shit. A little preemptive there on that. Hidden Blades does not work well on these guys for some odd reason. Great bear hide. Crap helmet. Need to get just over that ridge, and I'll have it.
Completely uncivilized.
No. And he died ass up. It's a terrible way to go. Can't help but feel bad for him. Alright, I think this is actually how we get it this time. We obviously got a little sidetracked by Templars and Great Bears, and I love killing stuff, but it's time to finally, here it is. Let's hit this frickin' thing. Get it out of the way. First one we encountered wasn't really hard at all. It's just like a zigzag back and forth. This one looks like it could be tricky. Do this. I already fucked this one up though. Because we got just about everything done. This is the very last part. And I started. Start from this point. Go boom, 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 boom. Got it. Okay, and what was I looking at? Here's the mother thing. Wanted to knock that out before I went too much farther. The rush of sigh. No. No, don't boogard me behind a bunch of fucking big rocks again, you son of a bitch. I think that's what's happening. I think once again I'm getting stuck behind a large number of big rocks that I cannot pass. If only I had a dwarf with their superior hopping ability. I could probably use my mount to make this faster, but it's so fucking horrendous, and in short, I keep forgetting to replace it. Like, every time I go by Skyhold, I forget to swap out to the other mount, and right now, it's just, ugh. It's one of the Dracolisks. It's just god-awful. I cannot stand how that thing looks. Happened up here. Beta's travel journal. I don't want to go to Ferelden and have to leave everything. My paintings, the cat, and worst of all, mother's little garden. So you killed yourself? How's that any way to deal with it? Anyway, whatever. Some rifts, and I'm gonna do that next. Save the rifts. So I'll hop over to the camp, head on down. I don't really need points anywhere. There we go. Easy choice that time. I mean, honestly, at this point, I'm just picking up passives to sweeten the pot on my character. She's obviously don't need any of their active abilities. I'm completely set there. I mean, I guess if I really wanted to, I could remove Mark of the Rift for something else, but I feel that that tends to pretty much carry its weight and usefulness high majority of the time. Horror. Two horrors, huh? Let's get in an attack, mates. How about we fuck up this one? There we go. Takes care of them. Ah, yes, and it wouldn't be a fight without Bull sundering open the earth and causing a giant stream of fire so bright that it is painful to the eyes. Where's? What am I doing? Ah, lover's promise. Am I supposed to light something over here? Actually, like. Ah. Yay! All right, and then we have observing the menace, and another camp. And another Astrium. So let's hit the other camp. We'll hit the camp, hit the third Astrium, and then we can knock that out and the other quests. And just to check, yeah, 14 minutes, so we're making pretty damn good time, I'd say. I mean, if I decided to go into all the rifts and shit, I could see this episode taking two more instead of one, but like I said, I'm looking to save some of those, because for the, oh, I don't know then again. I don't know. I need to have rifts to do the character video, especially the solo portion. Because just wandering around and looking for baddies to kill definitely isn't the most effective method of accomplishing those videos. And the rifts provide an excellent thing for me to go to where I know there's going to be enemies, and I know that it's usually challenging to at least a decent extent. Tell you what, though, I'm really fucking excited for this Vivian video. Like, The mage build is so fucking awesome. Just to give you guys a quick glance at how this works. basically, we have the same shit in Night Enchanter. We don't have the points for Disruption Field yet. But in Barrier, we get just regular Barrier. Work our way down. You gotta get Strength of Spirits. You also gotta get Rejuvenating Barrier. You don't need all the other shit, all the passives. Over in the Lightning Tree, we got Static Charge, which fucks up anything melee that comes near me with Paralyzing Power. We got Chaotic Focus in the Fire Tree, along with Fire Mine for single target burst, and then Immolate for AoE burst. In the Frost Tree, we got Winter's Grasp along with Chill to hold shit in place, along with Mana Surge, so that in the random off chance that our barrier does get broken, everything around me is getting frozen. And all in all, it is a lot of fun to play, because you know you're using shit from all three elemental trees at once. We get like Energy Barrage in the Lightning Tree, so you can really light some stuff up with that. And like I said, I tested it out earlier, and the only real fault currently was that my mana generation. You know what? Let me just fucking drop one of these out. Never used that ability. Oh, it's a pride demon. Watch this shit. Boom! Oh, Sarah, you were hilarious. I love doing that. Thousand cuts! Thousand cuts again! Both tier 3! Such absurd damage. Just for those that are curious, I know I've touched on this before briefly, but the Tempest Tree, you have an ability called Thousand Cuts. Right here. So, we're doing that, and what we're doing is we're using Flask of Fire with Unclenchable Fames, making it so abilities don't have cooldowns and they don't cost anything. And then we're using a tier 3 ability here, which is 38 hits times 300 weapon damage apiece for 11,400 weapon damage in a single burst, which, as you can probably guess, that's enough to basically shit on whatever we're fighting, you know. Pure fire essence, I bet that makes a badass rune of sorts. Yeah, so whether it's a level 17 pride demon on nightmare, or a dragon, or a cyclops, it's gonna shit on them. And then if you go even further with it, you can of course drop a mark of death on ahead of time and then do the 2,000 cuts. It's actually really hard to get mark and 2,000 cuts in and then detonate the mark, but you can do mark and then 1,000 cuts, and that works quite effectively. And then of course after the fact, do a have her drop her second one for. Pretty fucking OP. I mean, there's a lot of OP shit you can do in this game when you know what you're doing. A lot of really brutal combinations. Makes me happy I chose Sarah as my one of my companions, because she tears that shit up. And the last Astrium. Alright, what you got for me, puzzle? Oh, lordy, lordy. Well. No, what are you doing? Get back in there. We're not skipping it. Definitely one of the bigger ones, but it doesn't look that hard, so. Based on the pattern, there's a lot of following around. What I have to do is start. Yeah, I gotta start here. I th- think, because I have to end. No, hang on. I have to end it like that. Or I have to end it from the other way. No, I gotta end it from the other way. So I gotta end it right here to clean things up. Do this. Grab this area. I'm not sure if those two are connected. I don't think they are, but they might be. Awesome. Where's the cave? Where's the cave? Ooh, it's nice and close. What cool loot are we getting this time? Getting this time. I love cool loot. Let's go get some down inside the cave. Another fade rift. We got a shit all over. Oh, these guys. Mark go off. Shit. I'm missing, oh, never mind. I have it. It's just red out. Yeah. There you go. That's for you. Bad demons. Tell you what, one of these demons is getting insta-gibbed as soon as it spawns. Oh god. And you! Welcome, Pride Demon, to the show. Oh. Oh, and the burst. And he's stuck in the bubble. Oh, and the death blow and the re-stealth. We gotta take these little shits out. You are becoming a problem, sir. I'd like to speak to you about our Lord and Savior Super Dagger OP build. Oh, Rage Demon stuck in the bubble. Oh! Barriered my death flow, that little shit. Tell you what, nothing else, man. Playing on Nightmare is definitely keeping me on my toes. No easy joke. Pure lightning essence. I'm gonna make some really fucking badass runes from that stuff. Alright, so where is this at? Oh, it looks like it follows down into a trail, I think. So, do I really have to, like, loop all the way around to get down to it? Wasn't sure how everyone's doing on health, but they all look okay. You never even saw me, Big Bear. My god, it climbs trees! And the detonate! Oh no, I detonated it late! And the burst did not come. And the dagger build takes the Great Bear down. 8 hides? Jesus. Could clothe a small village of children with all those hides. Oh, hello, cat. What are you doing? No. No, kitty. My cat insists it thinks that my microphone is, like, meant to be nuzzled. And I'm like, no. As cute as that is, no, no. That is not what that is intended for. Let's not do that. You're gonna have to sit on my lap or you're gonna have to go away. You cannot fucking move your tail in front of my face and hit the control. Why not? Never hurts to get more bloodstone. Though I do want to make some really badass runes. I think I'll probably go... I don't know, I might go double lightning, just because I think lightning really fits a rogue, you know? You're all about speed. So I feel like lightning is a natural rune choice. Just, you know, it's good. I feel like it's good synergy, you know, given it's all just... Like, there's if I wanted to min-max for particular dragons or something like that, I could, but... If I have to pick one rune set, or one, not one rune set, but one element, I'm probably going to go with lightning, just because I feel like it's the thing to do for a rogue. Warrior, I'll probably go with fire. Mage, ice. What's in the good chest? Death ward, a staff. Well, Vivian, do we have a new toy for you? We do not. It is not even remotely close. Has a shit ton of constitution, which you do not need. Fantastic. 2% chance for unbowed on hit. That's actually pretty cool. But I have like all this shit I've been picking up in it. That's exactly what it is. It's like just shit gear that'll never get used. It's just gonna get sold. Oh, poor Vivian. When will we ever find a weapon that's better than what she currently has? I even tried crafting one, and the crafted weapon was, like, barely outclassing the one she has. So I didn't bother crafting it, but that's saying something, you know? So, looking over at the map real fast, because we are approaching that 30-minute mark, we still have Observing the Menace, couple rifts, which aren't all that important, a Lover's Promise, and one more camp. So, I suppose we will do one last episode in the Emerald Graves before you wrap up. And you know, that'll be good. It'll be, the whole day will have been Emerald Graves, which isn't too bad. So, either way, make sure to stay tuned, and we will catch you guys next time with the final part of Emerald Graves for Dragon Age Inquisition.